Hello, I'm Dr. Harsha Reddy. I'm consultant obstetrics and gynecology. I practice in Cloudnine Hospital, Sarjapur branch and the Bangalore branch in Bangalore. Fibroid is a growth in the wall of the uterus, to put it in simple terms. And almost always it is benign. That means it is not cancerous. It arises from the smooth muscle cells, and these are the cells which form the wall of the uterus. And again, to make it simple, based on the location, a fibroid can be protruding into the cavity of the uterus, which we call as a submucosal fibroid. A fibroid could be present in the wall of the uterus, which is called as an intramural fibroid, or it could be protruding outside, which is called as a subserosal fibroid. Now, coming to the question about laparoscopic surgery, removal of a fibroid is called as myomectomy, and we can opt for a laparoscopic route of removal of the fibroids if it is an intramural, that is within the wall, or protruding outside, that is subserosal. When we have to tackle a submucosal fibroid, we have to combine the hysteroscopic method along with the laparoscopic method. So the size of the fibroid which can be removed by the laparoscopic route is usually about 10 to 12 centimeters. However, the exact size or this size varies depending on a lot of factors, that is the surgeon's skill, experience and expertise, the total number of fibroids which are there in the uterus, size of each of these individual fibroids and the location of the fibroids. The location plays a very important part because it depends on whether it is present in the cervix, which may be difficult to access, or very low down in the back wall of the uterus, which we call as a posterior wall, technically a little bit difficult to suture it once the fibroid is removed, or it could be very close to the main vessel which is supplying the uterus, which we call as a uterine arteries, so which are the main arteries. So if it's present in the lateral wall, very close to the thing. But of course, these decisions can be taken as we are proceeding with the surgery. Laparoscopic myomectomy is a minimally invasive surgery. And nowadays, we also have a robotic myomectomy as well. Both these methods are very good alternatives to the open method or the abdominal myomectomy, especially in women who want to retain their uterus and who have fibroid-related infertility issues. Compared to an abdominal method or the open method, the advantages of either the laparoscopy or robotic is the size of the incision are smaller in the laparoscopic methods. You have a faster recovery following this procedure. The amount of blood loss is less and there are less additions following the surgery. So, laparoscopic myomectomy is usually chosen for a fibroid of around 10 to 12 centimeters and they should be less than 5 in number. However, the size of the fibroid which you can remove by laparoscopic method depends on individual circumstances. Fibroids greater than 10 to 12 centimeters are also removed, and more numerous fibroids can also be removed by laparoscopic method. And there have been papers which have been published which show that fibroids even up to 20 centimeters also have been removed by laparoscopy.